Let us, I guess, address this issue. And again, it's a taboo thing to talk about in the church. And I think we've touched on being gay because that's what we know best, as well as other things. But that's a big topic with our community that watches our videos. How do you feel about being an active minister, but on your downtime, you're on the gay sites? Or choir director, do you think it is wrong, or do you think that, you know, wherever you're gonna meet the person, especially if you're out, if you're a gay minister and you're out, then you never heard about the gay church?
Yeah, I heard about the gay church.
Yeah, so they're out. There's ministers who are out in the lifestyle and they practice, obviously, the lifestyle. But the different, and again, I don't understand it, but I understand it and I don't understand it. And I'm okay with it, can't judge you. But the question is, if you're to your congregation a minister, but yet still to your private life, you are hunting. And whether you're gay or straight, if you are on, you know, christianmingle.com.
But they, okay, just using that for example, christianmingle.com, that's, you know, for the Christians to mingle, you know.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, everyone needs love. Everyone's, you know, my thing is, because how many people you, okay, how many people you going to find in the church, like, really?
They're there, but, you know, most of the time.
But isn't that hunting as well?
Yeah. But again, honestly, you know.
Come on, no.
The Bible says a man that find a wife find a good thing. Hallelujah.
So it didn't say where.
I
was watching a divorce court the other day, and this, you know, divorce court. And the woman wanted, you know, whatever they was going for. But the thing is, why she called off the engagement, they wasn't even married yet. Why she called off the engagement, I don't know how you're in divorce court, you're in it. But anyway, the reason why she wanted a divorce or separation is because she found out the man have a fetish for S&M, and they met in the church. Now, so my thing, I say that to say,
everything thou shalt not beat me unless I ask for it.
Everything that's out there it's the same people. So my thing is, it's like, it is what it is. But you see, as a pastor, that's kind of because my thing is how. What if you on the pulpit and you see people in the congregation you was on jack with doing something? How do you, your authority is kind of off. Your leadership, how do you, that, I don't.
Well, I think that's where we need to have a community or a outlet for individuals, and I might get flagged for this, a bondage. Where do you find a decent man or a woman? Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know where the women go. Lickme.com. I don't know. I'm just saying. Where do you go and find a good woman? Because other than meeting friends through a friend,
yeah,
it's difficult as a lesbian to find a good helpmate.
Very difficult.
Because there's a whole lot of dead weight.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I hear the voice. But in the meantime, as a dude who are, you know, the dudes who are in leadership role in church, but on your downtime you are on Grindr, Jack, Adam for Adam, Men for Now, Now for Now, I don't know, whatever else is out there. Again, as a leader, I know you need love too, and I know you need to find, you want affection, but don't you feel guilty or feel funny about certain things? And again, some people don't have no shame tree, so it doesn't matter. And again, I'm not judging. I'm just saying, we as a community have forced certain people back in the closet more so than coming out and saying, you know what, I am gay as a minister, or I'm gay as a choir director. You know that I'm gay because obviously you can see me doing all of that stuff.
But I think that's the only alternative because, all right, unless they're in the gay church, as you said, if you're in, say, I don't think that nowadays, kind of as a time as a minister, you have to be married, have a wife.
Which is biblically, you should.
Supposed to have a wife, but there's a lot of ministers now that don't have wives. So my thing is,
because finding a woman is hard to find too.
So my thing is, okay, so then if you're a pastor and you're not married, and okay, so you are, it's kind of hard, you can't really, there's no way, there's no other option for you to be on those sites unless you find someone in the church. But then, you know, they're your clergy, what you call them? Your mm-hmm. clergy person, you know, mm-hmm. the one that come and carry your Bible and your cloth.
They're fucking with them too.
So it's like, I don't think there's no other option but to be on those things to find somebody.
Yeah, but I can't say, and again, to those of us who are on these sites, not knocking you, back in my days, MySpace, I was on. I think I still have a page on MySpace, but I'm not active on there. And if I do have a page on anything now, matter of fact, I do have a Jack page. And even though I'm married, or almost there, September, hello, I'm not on there looking for anything. What I do with the page that I created was to bring awareness to the community about HIV. So my page is Caution. And you know, you've seen the stuff I posted up, Caution campaign that I'm working on. But I think in everything that we do, we should be cautious. You know, as a minister, you going hunting for a, first of all, we gotta figure out, where are you in your life? Are you looking for a helpmate? Are you looking for a right now?
But the thing is with the pastor, it's gonna be a right now. It can't be a helpmate because you're gonna say, this is my first man, or you can't do it.
But again, unless why not?
Unless you're in a gay church.
Well, that's where we're going back to. We have problems with some straight people. Or some, funny thing is, some straight people are okay with folks being gay as long as you don't have a position in the church.
Right.
Because you don't want to, God forbid, you're being led by a gay person. Hello. And don't realize that some of the ministers you have in your church,
they're gay.
And even though they're married, they are gay. So, you know, not knocking them for trying it because you're bisexual, you can do that. You get like, you like fish, and you know, back in the days you used to take dick. I'm just saying. At the end of the day, whatever floats your boat, that's on you. I just want to say for the next generation of people coming up, because I find that when, if I take a survey of young people in our community and how much time period that they've spent in a relationship, most, I had a poll in the house one day where I asked a question. I mean, not a poll in my house, but I asked a question. So I took a survey in the room with people that are here. And I asked, what's the longest relationship you've been involved in? And I would say 95% of the people here said 2 years. So what happened after 2 years?
It's over.
So now, I can say the same thing for the lesbians. You know, what's the longest relationship some of them have been in? And they might say 2 years, they might say a year, they might say three, they might say four. But do we work through the shit?
But my thing is, sometimes you can't even get past the shit to work. You can't even get past the shit to work. I'm just saying, I'm being real. You can't
even get it. Hallelujah.
I'm just saying.
But you know, sometimes when we stop to sort things out, and you and I have talked off camera for years about the struggle with finding a helpmate. And we never talked about finding a helpmate that's a minister. Maybe you need to first lady. Hallelujah. But you know, in the same sense of dealing with sexuality, If the church was more open, or not the church, because the building itself is always open. When the people become more open to embracing folks and their walk, me sleeping with whoever I'm sleeping with has nothing to do with you. But recognize that as we bond, as I said to somebody the other day, I can have intimacy with you without physically being with you.
Right.
But that's when you open up to share, and I open up to hear, and I share, and you open up to hear. But when you want to tell me what you want in a dude, but you're still, you're not showing me what you're offering a dude. You're just looking for your shit to be filled.
Right.
But you're not offering nobody else anything. You know, when you look at church, again, church men, they're lonely. I mean, you can only hikamasai and speak in tongues, come in a Honda, but for so long. When you go home and you open that door, especially if you're independent and you open that door, you're now home alone, lonely. We who are gay, even at times we stray in the sense of pornography for entertainment. So them who are in leadership still looking for entertainment, you see what I'm saying? So I think they still have a desire to want love. But because it's not openly accepted in the church that they worship or in the church that they are leading or whatever, it's kind of difficult. So they're not forced to go in the back of the closet. So they will come home or after church or before church or whatever the case is, jump on Jack or Grindr or whatever else
to fulfill that side.
Right. And then because you have the insurance policy of our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, forgive me of my sins. And I think because we say that, it makes us, okay, we got a free pass.
Right.
Because God forgive us every time we ask for forgiveness. But just be honest where you are. You know, as a dude or as a female, that if you're struggling, say, yeah, I'm struggling. If you say, I want to, and again, we go to church or we know the church scriptures and we know these things, but we don't say it, we don't practice it. Ask and you shall receive. You know, most of us are in a conflict. Do you want to be delivered or it feels good, but I want to be delivered? You see what I'm saying? I got to the understanding where I'm comfortable with me. So, me being bisexual and I'm attracted to both sex, that's where I am. I embrace that. Some days I feel like a nut. How you doing? And other days I feel like going fishing. But I don't do both at the same time. I respect my partner and recognize that that is meant for me and him. But if I was open and I'd find a woman who likes what I am, then we'll deal with that too. But there's not a lot of women in the church who's willing to deal with a dude
that's bisexual.
That's bisexual. There's a lot of dudes in the church that is willing to deal with a woman that's bisexual.
Because that's a fantasy.
But if you're a Christian, you're not supposed to be having no threesomes.
Oh, please.
I mean,
it's me, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
that's the right menage a trois.
Yeah.
But, you know, it is something for us to discuss as a community. You know, why is such a taboo thing to have that conversation where we can talk to our young men who are now 16, 17, 18, and as much as they're in church, so to speak, and parents are forcing them to stay in church, there's a video recently that my partner saw and it brought it to my attention. And it was about a kid. He secretly videotaped his mom and father.
When he came out
to them.
Yeah, it was horrible.
And I thought to myself, you know,
it was horrible.
The mother saying on the video, she knew he was gay. But then in the same sentence, she turned around and said, you choose to be this way.
But you knew. But there's a lot of parents. Was he black?
No, he was white.
Okay. So a lot of parents know. But it's then when you actually say it, for them it becomes reality. Like, but you already knew. But this whole confirmation, you know, me saying it's like, wow, it's confirmed. So I think that just takes them to a whole nother place.
Why?
That's a parent.
But you're quicker to embrace
because they have
these, a whorish son.
Because they have hopes. This is they have these hopes and dreams for their kid. That's the whole thing.
We as a community, as a people, and I'm not saying this is a black thing or a white thing or a Spanish thing, but as a people, the ignorance that we have that was passed on from generation to generation.
It's a black thing.
Well, the young man who got his ass whipped by daddy and mommy.
Okay, but
there's some ignorance there too.
It's a Caribbean, that's Christ, that's church, and then it's a religious thing.
But, you know, we got to change the mindset of that. Because, you know, even when you think about embracing yourself, but you have to worry about what others going to think of you, then you'll never be comfortable.
Not at all.
You'll always be trying to keep up with the Joneses. And in the meantime, you're struggling with your shit. You know, a whole lot of folks are faking orgasms
to make their partner feel good. And you not being fulfilled.
So you as a woman who go, I really like and I'm attracted to a woman, but my mother and father would kill me if they found out that I had this thought or feeling. So I'm going to marry Tommy. And marry Tommy. Tommy not hitting you the way you're supposed to get hit. Because his tongue doesn't work quite just the same. And his fingers are kind of rough because, you know, he's a construction worker. So he might rip up and shut up. If I rip up and shut up things I'm not supposed to. You know, you sacrifice your whole identity for the greater good of a religion. And now, I hear it also, you know, in the overseas, wherever it was, they're saying that the men now who are Muslim, who it's a Muslim nation, that they are now being forced. If you say you're gay and you're coming out as you're gay, you have to get a sex change. Yeah, I heard about it last week. And I'm going, what the hell? So wait a second. So this must be for the feminine ones that says, well, I want the transition because you're that obviously cunt. Mm-hmm. Sorry for those of you. But for the man who penetrate, they don't need a sex change because you're not, they just flip up the sheet. They wear a robe. So you lift up the robe and you penetrate, whatever. It's funny to me how we tend to condemn these individuals who are finding themselves sexually. And I'm not saying that finding yourself meaning that you're sleeping with Tom, Dick, and Harry. I'm saying you're coming into identity for yourself. And yes, so you're now forced by a religious group or religion itself to be like almost condemned. You know, one of the other things I think I mentioned to you, we're in Jamaica, where your ancestors from. I was born there and raised there till I was 13. There's a group of young people there now called Gully Queens. And these are boys who are living in the gully. And they're forced underground. Like Teenage Mutant and Ninja Turtle, they're underground. Mm. Living in the sewer system because they can't publicly
be themselves.
So they only come out when night comes. But the problem is, Jamaica who is ignorant, Jamaicans who are ignorant to the reality of it, who, by the way, one of the dudes on the video that they have on YouTube, he was, you know, talking about Batman and them, you know, Nabilangia. And I'm looking at him, I was watching the video with a friend of mine at work, and I go, I can tell, my gaydar can tell, this one here, he himself, flip the light switch off, and he would transform to take a dick. So here you are, because you are passable, you can pass through, and as long as you go, the phrase to get you, the password to get you over to the other side, where they, you know, they don't judge you, is fire for a body man. And you go over to the other side and nobody say anything. Even though the tight pants you have on, we can see your camel toe. You know, so here it is where these young people, they're talking on video about their encounters, and some of them got shot at, some of them got stabbed up, but some of them talks about their truth of they're prostituting themselves. So here in Jamaica, who they're talking about Batman for dead, we have, I'm sure, ministers, we have policemen, we have all these people who are coming out in the nights when the light goes out, and they're now buying sex from these same individuals who have to live in the sewers. So in my understanding of that, I'm going, but wait a second. It's economics, supply and demand. When I'm watching this, I go, wait a second. So they have outfits that are dressed like women. They have a makeup like women. The man who picking them up knows that they're not really women, but yet still, you'll pay how many hundreds or thousands of dollars, Jamaican dollars, for the sex. But yet still, you'll come out later on in public and cuss them out and deny them. So there is a movement about that, which I think we all as Jamaicans who are gay or bisexual or lesbian should support where you came from. You know, and I'll go back to the original of, you know, as a minister, do you want love? Do you find love? Where do you find love? You shouldn't have to find love in a gully queen in order to come out in the night to find happiness. If you have a congregation of young people in your church or older folks in your church, if it comes down for you to stand in your truth to say, you know what, I feel this way, and whether or not I'm going to lose my congregation, I'd rather start off from scratch with new congregation other than lie to myself and lie about my identity.
Not a lot of them are strong enough to do that, to sacrifice their congregation.
So we would rather lie in the struggle and creep out in the night to go on Jack Grinder, Adam Man for Now, and all them other ones, other than to face your truth.
Because that seems easy.
And then years down the road, or months down the road, when you're now popping up sick because you were infected with HIV, we don't want to address it. So now we go, he has a cold, or he has cancer. And I think that's where we as a community gotta face the fact of, you know what? We cannot allow other folks to be our barrier. We have to break through our ignorance. We gotta break through our bullshit and face our fact, face our truth. Are you a minister? And if you're a minister, then so be it. I think we minister in our own way. We try to, you know, motivate and encourage young people and anybody who's watching this. We try to motivate people. But we want them to motivate themselves also by standing in their truth. If you're a lesbian, be proud to be a lesbian. If you are gay, be proud to be gay. Listen, it's 2015. Come out of the fucking closet. It's time. Step up in your truth and deal with your reality. Your reality is, if you don't face yourself and love yourself, who will? You can't say you're looking for a prince, and yet still you're not willing to come out and stand out as a prince.
Right.
You know, Beauty and the Beast is a fairy tale. And most of us, yes, we are beasts in the sense of behavior, because we want sex every week, every month, and we are randomly doing Russian roulette on these sites, and we're not being safe about it.